Matapos sumalang sa pagdinig sa kamera, sa Senado naman haharap ang dating driver bodyguard at karalesyon ni at umano'y bagman ni Senadora Lila de Lima na si Ronnie Dayan. Makakaharap niya rito ang Eastern Visayas drug lord na si Kerwin Espinosa. Kaugnay riyan, mga kapanem natin si Attorney Rosario Reyes, ang National President ng Integrated Bar of the Philippines o IBP at IBP Officer Attorney Manny Buenaventura. Magandang umaga sa inyo, Attorneys Reyes and Buenaventura.
Magandang umaga rin sa inyo, Howie.
Okay, you were both at the hearing, no, sa kamera nung Webes. Ano yung papel ng IBP doon? Bakit kayo yung umupo doon sa pagdinig bilang mga abogado ni Ronnie Dayan? Kayo, ma'am.
Ito kasi si Attorney Manny Buenaventura is my presidential assistant on legislative affairs. He called me up and asked me if it is possible for IBP to provide a lawyer for purposes of taking the affidavit of Dayan, who at that time was already apprehended or arrested and was already in the custody of the PNP and later on ng Congress.
Walang sariling abogado itong si Ronnie Dayan. Kaya sino yung tumawag po sa Integrated Bar of the Philippines, which is the Association of Private Lawyers, no?
Yes,
in the Philippines?
Yes, all lawyers. It is the official organization of all lawyers in the Philippines. So, basta abogado ka at nasa role of attorneys ka na Supreme Court, miyembro ka po ng IBP.
So in the absence of a lawyer, Ronnie Dayan needed one from the IBP to help him prepare his affidavit, which is a legal document.
Yes, yes.
So doon niya isinalaysay itong mga pangyayari, ano, whether he met Kerwin or not, what he did with Senator De Lima, etc. So instead of the private instead of the public attorney's office, kayo yung kinontak. Kasi usually, yun ang iniisip ng publiko, na may public attorney, ano, as opposed to the IBP. But IBP pala also provides free legal aid.
It's part of the mandate of the Integrated Bar of the Philippines to provide competent and free legal services to indigent people, no? So, parang pau din po kami. Kung hindi po pwede ang PAW at may allegedly may conflict of interests, ang IBP po ang natatawagan para mag-provide ng legal assistance. But in this particular case, it was the chairman of the Committee on Justice of Congress who requested Attorney Manny Buenaventura for IBP a lawyer.
Si Congressman Umali ang nag-request sa
inyo. Opo, opo.
Not Ronnie Dayan himself.
No, not Ronnie Dayan.
Because he didn't have a lawyer, so si Congressman. So si Attorney Manny Buenaventura, kayong umupo doon sa tabi ni Ronnie Dayan sa pagdinig mismo?
I was a part of the interview. I was there when his testimony was taken at the...
This is before the hearing.
Before the hearing. And I was there seated beside him to ensure that his rights were properly protected in the course of the hearing.
At sa palagay ninyo, his rights were protected during the hearing?
I believe so. There was no objection raised during the hearing.
Okay, sir, may mga pumupo na medyo nabastusan sila doon sa ibang tanong kay Ronnie Dayan. It went beyond the boundary of, you know, proper questioning kayo. Pareho kayong abogado, no? Mga puro abogado din yung mga nagtanong kay Ronnie Dayan. During this hearing, did you get a sense na medyo overboard na yung ibang tanong yung tungkol doon sa kung anong signal yung naging physical intimacy ni Ronnie Dayan at ni Senadora De Lima, yung paggamit ng salitang climax, etc. Were you noticing this during the hearing, and ano yung naging reaction niyo?
Well, from the perspective of a lawyer, the relevant question is, is it relevant to the matter under investigation? I think, well, many of the questions were cannot be questioned on that point because they all related to the degree of relationship between Mr. Dayan and the other personalities involved in the subject of the investigation.
Okay, so tama lang yung ganong klaseng mga tanong, and even the way it was worded. But ma'am, you were also there, no? And you're a woman, no? Mukhang parang may gender divide yung mga reaction dito sa mga pagtatanong, no? You normally hear those kinds of questions in a court?
I was not there during the interpellation because I had to leave to attend another meeting at the Supreme Court. But ay
nabalitaan niyo.
Yung mga napapanood ko sa TV at nababalitaan ko. Ako po kasi litigator din naman po ako. Mm-hmm. And most of the congressmen there were are lawyers and mm-hmm. were litigators before they became congressmen. Mm-hmm. So nakita nila yung, sa tingin ko po, nakita nila yung kahalagahan na maipakita yung kung gaano yung relasyon, alleged relationship between Diane and the senator to the point na pwede siyang pagkatiwalaan mm-hmm. at pwedeng mautusan ng mga bagay-bagay na medyo sensitibo.
So they have
parang
to establish.
Sa tingin ko po, yun po yung naging objective. Now, there are lawyers, litigators who can ask 3 or 4 questions and will be able to elicit that kind of information, no, that they needed. But there are some lawyers who will have to ask 10 or more questions. Kumbaga, siguro mas gusto nila na mas ano yon yung anong tawag sa Tagalog noon yung may ilarawan ng maigi mm-hmm. kung anong klaseng relasyon mm-hmm. meron sila.
So they had to probe kung ano opo, mismo yung relationship. Opo. So doon sa kayong tumulong sa paghanda ng affidavit, no, you didn't get the sense and I'm just echoing what others have mm-hmm. Kind of suggested, no, may script na sinusunod itong si Ronnie Dayan, kasi may nagsasabi na scripted daw itong mga testimonya niya. There are some medyo incredible aspects of it, no? Well, nung kausap nyo, did you get that sense?
No, I can say that it was not scripted because if you recall, si Dayan was arrested and the interview took place immediately after his arrest. And considering the time intervening, there was no opportunity to concoct or to prepare any script for the testimony. And there were no prepared questions. The questions were propounded based on the committee report and the affidavits and record. And in my observation, Mr. Ronnie Dayan answered spontaneously and reacted immediately to questions propounded.
Okay, kasi of course may umiikot na itong rumor na may conspiracy to para drugin itong si Senadora Laila de Lima because she's been one of the most outspoken critics of the president. You don't represent Ronnie Dayan anymore, no? So kumbaga mga observers kayo dito sa proseso na to. You didn't get that sense na off camera and overhearing na any of the lawmakers at this committee, wala kayong sense na gano'n, na parang they're trying to get Ronnie Dayan to kind of pinpoint Laila de Lima, even according to a particular plan.
Yeah. Well, as far as the proceedings that we participated in were concerned, we were independent observers, we were independent counsels, and we did not observe any type of conspiracy or any type of script. It was voluntary, it was independent, it was not coerced. The questioning was spontaneous, the answers were spontaneous, freely and voluntarily given.
Okay, may mga pumansin na may inconsistencies daw itong testimonya ni Ronnie Dayan at yung testimony ni Kerwin Espinosa. They got certain things wrong, like the year of a certain transactions and that kind of thing. Kayong mga abogado, itong mga inconsistencies, does this mean na iniimbento itong mga kwentong to, or they didn't follow a particular script, or talagang minsan talaga kahit gusto mo magsabi ng totoo may inconsistencies yung testimony?
So tingin ko kasi yung what has been established so far on the basis of the testimony given by Mr. Dayan and Mr. Espinosa is the fact that monies were delivered to and received by Mr. Dayan from Mr. Kerwin Espinosa. Now, the inconsistencies appear to be on the dates, no? Mm-hmm. So, and what is material to me to be able to establish yung sinasabi ni Mr. Ronnie Dayan na hindi na siya nakatanggap ng pera during a particular date because he was no longer
employed
with the Department of Justice. the best evidence there would be the resignation letter. If it can't be produced, then mm-hmm. that would substantiate or prove that, or maybe in fact, that he could not have received any money anymore from Kerwin Espinosa. But you know, the mere fact that you have not, that you have resigned from the office, is not enough also to establish that, no? Kasi pwede
but, because if they were having a relationship,
yes,
pwedeng maging companion na lang instead of the bodyguard, diba? Kung inaamin naman ang dalawa na nagkaroon silang relasyon. Gaano kalakas sa palagay ninyo yung testimonya ni Ronnie Dayan?
Well, ang kasi nga, because this is an extrajudicial declarations, so these are, these statements or declarations can be taken in evidence against Mr. Dayan. No? Kasi yung pagtanggap niya ng pera, yung inutusan siyang...
Admission of guilt yun?
Not necessarily. Kasi pag admission of guilt, ibig sabihin po parang may kaso na. Wala naman pong kaso pa eh.
So but it can be used against him.
Well, later on, maybe, yeah. It can be used as an evidence against him to establish yung kung ano man yung alleged na pagtanggap niya ng pera. Dininay naman niya na hindi nga niya alam kung galing ba yung pera niyan sa illegal drugs. Hindi ba? Napakaklaro yun sa testimony ni Mr. Dayan.
Okay, kung hindi niya alam yun, eh, tumanggap lang siya ng pera mula kay Kerwin Espinosa, is that considered a crime? He's not a public official.
Parang lumalabas na, inutusan lang siya. Role naman yun dahil driver siya. Pero, so it's really up to...
But that has to be proven pa.
To the prosecution to establish, to get more evidence to establish.
Kasi malinaw lang po na tumanggap siya
tumanggap
ng pera
siya
kay Kerwin. But that by itself is not necessarily a violation of the law.
Dahil inutusan siya, sabi niya, di ba?
Yun ang violation. Pero yun hindi pa napapatunayan.
Ngayon, hindi rin niya alam kung na yun pala ay galing sa illegal drugs, no? So yung admission lang niya is to the extent that tumanggap siya ng pera from Kerwin, pero hindi niya sinasabi na alam niya kung saan ang galing yung pera na yun. Ginawa niya yun dahil inutusan lamang siya.
Okay. So, we have to wrap up, attorneys. But final point lang about the Integrated Bar of the Philippines. Mm-hmm. So you have a free legal aid program for the indigent.
Mm-hmm.
Is there a website where people without lawyers can go and ask for free legal advice or a lawyer in case they need one?
Yes. The flagship project of the IBP is the legal aid program. No? Mm-hmm. So we have the national office where they can go. This is in Pasig. And we have 85 chapters nationwide where each chapter has a legal aid committee. People from those places can also go to IBP to ask for legal assistance, free legal assistance.
Okay, for anyone, hindi lang itong mga high-profile personalities katulad ni Ronnie Dayan.
Lalong-lalo na po sa mga taong who cannot afford to engage the services of a private lawyer.
Okay, that's great to
opo.
Know. Okay, all over the Philippines.
Yes, opo.
Meron pala mga libreng abogado.
Opo.
Okay, thank you for that service. Maraming salamat po sa inyong oras, Attorney Rosario Reyes, ang Pangulo ng Integrated Bar of the Philippines. At si IBP Officer Attorney Manny Beneventura.
Yes.